Good morning, guys. Today is Saturday, and I just finished up my workout this morning. Today's workout was like a kickboxing cardio workout, and I am honestly sore from literally my head. Like, my neck is sore down to my toes. Like, my whole body is so sore from doing the group classes every day this week. I work really hard in them, and then I kind of supplement in where I need to any extra cardio or lifting that I feel like I need to do in addition to those classes. So overall, I've worked really hard this week. I feel like this is probably the hardest I've worked in the gym since prep, and I kind of have like those feelings back about the gym again, like just being really excited to go to the gym, do my workouts, you know, coming back to the gym, like any, you know, I just felt more motivated and it wasn't hard to get to the gym or be in the gym this week. So that's been like a really good feeling that I needed. Even though I've been getting myself to the gym prior to this, I definitely wasn't working as hard or feeling as like purposeful in my workout. So that's been a great change. I did weigh in this morning and I weigh exactly the same, 120.6, that I have the past couple weeks. So that was like a bit irritating to see after working so hard, upping my cardio. I just feel like things should be changing. It's grueling how hard I'm working in the gym, so I feel like my body should be changing. And maybe it is, right? Like, I did not take pictures today, so I can't really compare to see those changes that may not be shown on the scale. So this is where you have to remind yourself, like, all right, so I'll lay it out for you. This is where my mind goes. Okay, so I weigh exactly the same, working balls to the wall in the gym, eating whole foods on this paleo style right now, which isn't easy for me. It's very challenging, actually. Putting in all this effort, and my weight is exactly the same. So your mind can go to, well, why don't I just go back to not having to work so hard in the gym and not paying attention to my diet and eating as mindfully if I'm just gonna weigh the same? So that mindset can happen easily, and that's when people throw in the towel. And I can feel that way too, because I certainly did this morning, not where I wanted to throw in the towel, but I was just like, huh, that's irritating. But yes, let's remind ourselves that changes do take time. And really, I think we're so used to seeing, like, on TV, you see Biggest Loser, people lose 10 pounds in a week, or people that do extreme dieting, and even for prep, you get used to seeing weight loss every time you step on the scale, at least once a week. And so when you're just being a normal person and trying to eat healthy, you're not gonna see weight loss every week. You're not gonna see on the scale, you're not gonna see that number change all the time. It doesn't mean that changes aren't happening. It doesn't mean good things aren't happening. And I can say focusing on other factors, such as like my appetite, my motivation, my sleep has been improved. Like, I'm sleeping better. And that could be because of the super hard early morning workouts. But there's other things to focus on other than the scale to measure your success. So while I don't see huge changes when I look at my body right now or the way I fit into my clothing, I'm happy that I'm fueling my body really good. I'm happy that I'm working out really hard. That makes me feel better about myself. And it's good to feel good about yourself and not have that be associated with a set number on the scale. So anyways, with that, I'm gonna continue paleo. I'm not, like, this week I wasn't really loving it, to be honest with you. I found it a bit difficult, but I'm trying to continue to push myself through it and just be better. Like, it pushes me outside of my comfort zone because I can't eat convenience style, which is what I like to do. You know, and it's not that I'm lazy, you guys. It's not that I don't like to cook and love to cook. You have to understand, my life is literally being away from my home for the majority of the day. When you start your day at 4 a.m. and you don't get home till 7 p.m. at night, and you're gonna start your day at 4 a.m. the next day, it's a lot. It's challenging to have all your food prepped and to have it be, you know, varied and to have it be delicious. And it's so, you know, for me, my lifestyle has often included like healthy eating on the go if I needed to, and I do a really good job with that. I know how to go out to eat, make good choices that, you know, don't impact my weight too much. So it's been hard for me, you know, to adjust to this, but it's good to push yourself outside of your comfort zone. So I'm actually gonna go to the store. When I was doing some like list cardio, I was looking up some different breakfast recipes. So I'm gonna go to the grocery store now and just make something up different for breakfast than what I've been eating this week. Also, as much as I don't want to, but I'm gonna start tracking macros. I tracked yesterday just to see, like, as I mentioned last week, if you've been watching these videos, I was feeling like I've been low on protein. And so yesterday I made a good effort to try to make sure I got more protein in. And when I tracked it all, I was only at 70 grams. So I ate one more meal before I went to bed, which put me at 90 grams of protein, which for my body weight and for how hard I'm working in the gym, I just don't feel like that's enough. So I am gonna continue to track just to see where I'm at and make sure mostly that I'm getting enough protein and that I'm not just like getting all fats. Like, I'm not doing a keto diet. I'm not trying to put myself in ketosis. There's no need for me to have 90% of my diet from fat. Not saying it was, but you know, I while doing paleo, I think I need to track. I really want it to be able to lose weight doing intuitive eating. And I do believe that you can. However, with this paleo approach being so different for me, I think I need to. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna check with Danica. I don't believe I'm gonna follow set numbers just yet. I think I'm just going to eat how I'm eating and track it and just kind of assist me with being more mindful of making like better planned out meals with a little bit more protein. It's just still hard with like the organic grass fed. Like, I don't know. I can't do all organic grass fed if I'm gonna get my protein in. Not having whey protein, not doing cheese, Greek yogurt, things like that used to supplement in. So, you know, I'm pretty good about doing like 70 grams of protein from eggs and meat. But beyond that, I used to have some protein. So it's just a change, and I think I'm gonna get some different fish or something today to spice it up. And yeah, that's all the morning updates for right now. So I'm gonna head to the store and we'll see after. Just spent way too long in Wegmans getting the stuff that I needed. And breakfast is gonna take me a little bit to make. So I did pick up one of these RX bars, which if you look at the ingredients, that's all there is to it. Egg whites, pecans, cashews, dates, and no BS. This is the maple sea salt flavor. So yeah, paleo approved. So I'm gonna have this guy while I drive home, which is 10 fat, 22 carb, 5 fiber, and 12 grams of protein. So that'll tide me over because it's like 10:30 now, and then I won't be so moody when I get home. Bruce looking dynamite after his bath last night. Looking so good. All right, so I didn't get too much at the grocery store, even though I was there for like an hour, because I like to look at everything. Thought I'd show you real quick a few of the things that I picked up. I truly just went in for the items I wanted for breakfast. So if this gives you any idea of how I shop and why Jason probably doesn't like to shop with me, because I'm annoying. But I did grab all things fall. I like having flowers out, so I've got these sunflowers. I'm gonna put those little pumpkins in there with it. This should look cute. Over on the table, I've got the flowers over there looking a little sparse, so I'll add those to it. Bruce, what are you doing under the table? So I picked up a zucchini, an organic zucchini, organic red bell pepper, and then I got this delicata squash, which I bought one last year and never ended up doing anything with it. So today, I'm definitely gonna eat this with one of my meals. I got some green onion, sweet potato. This is all they had. I don't know why they didn't have like normal sweet potatoes out. Organic kiwi. I'm not sure if this is really paleo, but it's turkey sausage. I don't really know why it wouldn't be. It's just turkey with spices added to it. There's no sugar. It's like garlic powder.
So I got that. I got some wild caught haddock for Jason and I. And then I got these fresh turkey breast cutlets, which are no antibiotics, no added hormones. And then because I was just talking about how I like convenience, as you saw, I ate one of those RX bars. So I grabbed a few more just to have on hand. Because I like having a little something convenient like that. Grabbed a couple of these Bragg's apple cider vinegar drinks because I like those a lot. And I picked up some caramel apple tea, almond meal flour, which I'm probably gonna bake with a little bit. And the stuff I had was expired. And then this is what always racks my bill up, is I buy toiletry stuff at the grocery store, which is so expensive, but I had to grab some color safe shampoo conditioner. And then I needed a new beauty blender because I think mine is dirty and there's no turning back from it. And some nail polish that's supposedly, that's a fun word to say, supposed to help strengthen your nails, which mine are not good right now. They're like so fragile from getting like gel and dip nails. So I need to just like be kind to my nails. And I grabbed a new blush, L'Oreal True Match. And this is in the color Tender Rose. So that's my little haul.
Not giving a fuck is a beautiful thing when it's a Saturday. I like how you already panned down on my outfit. How'd you know I was gonna say that? Is being at Lowe's on a Saturday wearing your Batman t-shirt, your Nike sweatpants, which the husband bought me for my birthday, and I love, with no makeup's on. We're gonna go buy some adult bangs. Welcome to another recipe video, Kara Corey. You're here cooking in my kitchen with me. Today's menu, we're eating paleo.
What you cooking up?
Peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Toasted. I'm gonna get yelled at. After what, an hour in Lowe's? What feels like an hour? We got some shades for the dog room, so he hopefully can't eat those. A bunch of light bulbs, different varieties, so we have the right lighting for
YouTube.
The YouTube
light.
Strictly magic erasers are seriously magical. You need these in your life. And then some grass seed. So I was just outside eating dinner, watching Jason and Bruce play in the yard, and the sky looks ridiculous. So we're hoping you guys can see it. It looks like really textured is the only way to describe it. Oop. It's crazy. Yes, master.
Stay. Okay. And he's not even 8 months old yet.
These are the little moments in life that you can't take for granted. With all the suffering and bad shit that goes on, you need to remember to appreciate the little things, which I feel like I'm very good about. Just the little things like how beautiful the sky looks, and that I'm so fortunate I get to have this view. And this dog. And this husband.
And these curls that aren't.
And
really
those curls that are a touch fluffy because he finally washed them. But these ringlets are still going strong. Look at those tendrils.
I can't wash my hair every day. It just gets fucking crazy.
It looks better when it's like a week dirty.
It does.
Do something on a Saturday night. Woo! Getting wild. Actually, no. Bruce is like, what? What the hell's going on? We are getting ready to go out and go to some haunted houses. And it's like a 40-minute trip or so, but it's been beautiful out. It like cooled down a little bit, so it's perfect weather to go stand outside and get all spooky. So we're gonna head out and do that. I'm excited. Let the horror begin. You guys, we just made it to Frightmare Farms. I don't know why that's so hard to say, but the chainsaws are already going off. We're gonna see what this is all about. There's some screams going on.
Wow, Frightmare Farms is like next level.
So scary. It was like almost like Universal style. We just finished up the haunted houses and we were both super impressed with it. I can't believe we've never gone there before because it's actually not too far from us. But very impressed with the amount of work they put into it. I was scared a bunch of times. It was really cool because it wasn't like you were in with a big group of people. So I was kind of like, I usually walk first and Jason's behind me. So there was three separate little events we did. The haunted house, the labyrinth, and then a haunted trail. So they're all really good. So if you guys are in the area who follow this channel, I highly recommend it. It was definitely worth the money. So now, like, if you can tell, my voice is like really dry from screaming and stuff. So we're at the gas station. We're gonna get some waters and then head home and go to bed. So this is going to conclude this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it and we'll see you for the next one.